Thielen. You know, he's not getting much love, and I thought maybe it was injury or something, but he's not injured right now, and he had a great preseason showing. I think he's getting a little disrespected just because I think he had so many catches and yards and had such a great year. It'll be hard to live up to that, and usually most guys regress and everything. But Kirk Cousins loves to throw the ball, and he loves to throw it to Adam Thielen. You know, he's got Stephon Diggs, but they'll both get enough targets. I mean, Adam Thielen's going to have another huge year. If you're in a PPR league, you got to have him at the top of your list because he's going to get receptions no matter what. How many yards, you don't know, but he'll get touchdowns because he's tall, and he'll get his receptions because he has some great hands, some of the best in the league. So Adam Thielen's going to have another big year. There's just no denying that. I don't know why he's so down. Maybe I am a little worried about injuries too. I get it. He was banged up, but I think it's safe to say I think he'll be healthy this year, and I think the Vikings are going to be really good. So I think he'll have another really big year. You know, even if he goes down a little bit, that's still a great year. So draft Adam Thielen with confidence. Julian Edelman at 12. He's going to have a big year because, you know, I think he's not going to be suspended for 4 years. I know that, but I'm saying I think Brady will throw more than people think. They're not just going to be this run all the time team. And he throws to Edelman. He doesn't have Rob Gronkowski left. Who else is he throwing to? I love N'Keal Harry. Don't get me wrong. Love him. Think he'll have a huge rookie year. That's great. If, you know, Josh Gordon comes in, which he will, that would take some receptions. Who else they got, though? Philip Dorsett? I mean, you could draft Julian Edelman with confidence because, you know, he's the slot receiver. If you're in a PPR league, you've got to draft him because he's going to have, you can have 10 catches most games. I mean, that's 10 points right there. So, unless you do that half-point PPR bullshit, that's fine. But I don't know why everyone's doing that all of a sudden, but whatever. Julian Edelman will have a big year PPR-wise, and yards-wise, it'll be pretty good. It'll be around 1,900 at the least. And, you know, he'll score some touchdowns. Maybe not a ton. You know, that's probably his only weakness, but he'll get the yards. He'll get the receptions. I mean, and he's going to play a ton. He's going to try to make up for that four-game suspension. He's Brady's most trusted and reliable target. And why would you not want the best quarterback in the league's most reliable and trusted target? So that's all I'll say on that. You know, if you know what you're doing, you'll draft Julian Edelman in the right spot. He'll be your wide receiver too, and you'll be good to go. All right, number 13, T.Y. Hilton. I'll admit, I did this list before Andrew Luck retired. Now that Andrew Luck has retired, T.Y. Hilton takes a hit, I'm not going to lie. I have some faith in Jacoby Brissett, though. I like Jacoby Brissett. I think after playing a ton, you know, the year before last, I think he has the experience. He played well in New England, subbing in for Brady when he was suspended. I mean, Jacoby Brissett can play, and if you remember when he played 2 years ago, T.Y. Hilton was his favorite target, and T.Y. Hilton didn't really suffer. He had a lot of big receptions for touchdowns. And T.Y. Hilton, I've read he looks terrific at camp, the best he's ever looked. He looked young, he's fast, you know, making moves. He looks the best in camp. All the coaches are raving about him. He looks so good. I've just read rave reviews that he looks terrific. And, I mean, Jacoby Brissett's going to throw to who he trusts, his best player, his best receiver. Why not throw it to T.Y. Hilton? I mean, they have to throw the ball. They can't just be San Diego State. They can't run every single time. They're going to be throwing the ball. And Jacoby Brissett is in the NFL. He's not, you know, completely. It's not me going out there and throwing on a six-pack of beer or something. I mean, Jacoby Brissett can hit the guy, and T.Y. Hilton's fast. If he's in great shape, if he's doing well, T.Y. Hilton's going to have a big year. Watch it. I think he's still a sleeper. And now if you do your draft and Andrew Luck retired, I bet T.Y. Hilton's being drafted so late on the board, you can grab him for a bargain, and that could be your best value pick of the draft. I mean, you get T.Y. Hilton at a good spot, you are not going to regret that. Trust me, T.Y. Hilton can now be my sleeper of the draft practically. He is worth the draft. Definitely draft him if you get him late. Definitely do that. Trust me on this one. You can yell at me personally if he doesn't work out, but I'm putting a stamp on it. I feel like ball and stamp, I guarantee he will have a big year, at least 1,000 yards, at least 6-7 touchdowns, maybe. All right, number 14, Stephon Diggs. I think the Vikings will have a really big year. They'll get at least win one playoff game, maybe. I mean, they'll be up there. They'll have a good year. Kirk Cousins loves to throw the ball for 500 yards and a few touchdowns, a few interceptions. I mean, he'll throw the ball. So there's enough yards and balls to go around for Stephon and Adam Thielen. You know, so he'll get his targets. He'll have his big games. And Thielen will have big games. But they never have that bad of games, you know. I don't think they have too many duds, complete ones. Stephon does, actually. So that's maybe their only difference. That's why Adam Thielen's ranked much higher than Stephon usually. So Stephon is a little boomer bust, but not really. I mean, he'll have a good year again. He could end up being much higher than 14, really. Stephon's just, he's kind of like that mid to high, like he's, I don't see him making that break to being an elite top of the class receiver, but I see him being still on that high, middle to high echelon of receivers. You know, he could have about a big year this year, bigger than expected, so I would not feel bad if I had Stephon Diggs as my second receiver, so draft him with confidence out there, why not? Number 15, Amari Cooper. I think, you know, whether or not he gets the contract, he's going to have a pretty big year. Dak obviously loves him. I think Dak Prescott is going to have a pretty big year. I think he'll get paid. And by the preseason and just by the way he sounds and looks, I think he's happy regardless. He's ready to have this huge year. You know, everyone thought he was going to have a huge year last year. Had that sophomore slump, kind of. I think he's ready to bounce back, prove all the haters, doubters, and critics wrong. I really do think he'll have a really big year. Especially if Ezekiel gets there, then draft Amari Cooper with confidence, because they're going to have, they could even go close to the Super Bowl. They're a great offense, great offensive line, of course, still. Amari Cooper, I think Michael Gallup will have a big year, though. He's going to really, you know, become a huge star, I think. He's going to break out of that rookie shell. So Michael Gallup will have a lot of targets and yards, too, but he's going to throw in Amari Cooper. I mean, he's going to, so, you know, Amari Cooper is going to have a big year. He'll break 1,000 yards for sure, and I bet he'll have a lot of touchdowns. I mean, you know, yeah, Jason Witten might take those. There'll be some touchdown snipers, but draft Amari Cooper with confidence. He's going to have a big year, trust me. But regardless if he gets paid or not, he'll have a big year. He's looking to prove. If he doesn't get paid, it might even be better because he wants that contract. So Amari Cooper's going to have a big year no matter what. Number 16, Chris Godwin. This is my value / sleeper pick of the draft. K-Mac sleeper pick. I feel like ball and value pick. Stamp it all on there. I think he'll have a huge breakout year. I mean, I think Jameis Winston's just going to have a huge year. I'm just, all my chips, I'm sliding them in there. All my chips are in the Jameis Winston bag. So I think there's enough balls to go around for O.J. Howard, Mike Evans, and Chris Godwin to have big years. Seriously, I love O.J. Howard too. Maybe not as much as some people think he's going to have a crazy good year. I think he'll have a good to great, but not. Some people are saying he'll be great. I think that will be Chris Godwin. I think he's going to break through. He looked good in preseason already. I had him last year and he was playing well. He could have been an RB3 last year. I think this year he'll definitely be RB2 status, if not RB1. Watch out for Chris Godwin. I would guarantee it. He's going to have a big year. We're going to be talking about him really high up next year. He could even get traded, you know, or the Bucks. Maybe they'll just get good. They'll have Mike Evans and Chris Godwin and O.J. Howard. They'll re-sign Jameis Winston, and they'll be contending for Super Bowls. Hey, okay? I'm here for the hot takes. My hot takes, it's sizzling right now. That's a hot take. Buccaneers could be a playoff team this year. If not, they're contending for the Super Bowl next year. They get a running game down if Ronald Jones second, if he starts playing like he should and could. They're going to be a good team. They're going to be a team to mess with. So check out Chris Godwin, I'm telling you. I mean, you can not listen to me all you want, but trust me, if I were you, I'd draft Chris Godwin. You heard it here first. I don't care if you heard it somewhere else. You heard it here now more defiantly than anywhere else. Chris Godwin's going to have a humongous year. Tell him Kevin K. McCarthy said it. Chris Godwin for breakout wide receiver of the year. Next pick. Number 17, Robert Woods. Screw it. Let's do 18 too. Brandon Cooks is 18. Robert Woods is 17. This is the LA Rams wide receiver core. Just so happens they're 17 and 18. I like Robert Woods. He's reliable. He's a good RB2 if you get him. If you can get him for your RB2, I'm not mad at that. I think Cooper Kupp might have it down here because of the injury and everything. So Robert Woods will step up a little bit. I think he's quiet. People tend to forget about him. But Robert Woods will have a solid quality year, 900 yards, good receptions, some touchdowns. He'll have a solid quality year. Very reliable RB2. He'll never have duds of games. He'll always be about that middle of the line, that high middle class, that upper middle class level. I know very well. That's where he'll be. He'll be not in the mansion, but he'll at least still be in the suburbs. He might even be on the cul-de-sac, with the real upper class, upper middle class. He might make that leap this year, but hopefully he doesn't have much time left. So Robert Woods, draft with confidence as an RB2, RB3 even. Brandon Cooks, I never trusted him much. He's too up and down for me. I don't know. I guess he had a good year last year, but you guys can draft Brandon Cooks. Brandon Cooks is my shaky pick of the day. I don't know how much I trust him. So Brandon Cooks, draft at your own risk. Kenny Galladay, I love him this year. I think he's going to have a really big stepping up year. I don't think Marvin Jones Jr. is too much of a threat to his targets. And then you got TJ Hockenson, who I love, in Detroit. But I think Matthew Stafford will have a pretty good year. I think the Detroit offense will be pretty good. But Kenny Galladay is like a mini Calvin Johnson. He's, people don't talk about him much, but he's tall as hell. He's like 6'5". He can catch a lot of balls that other receivers can't. He can moss. He can moss anyone. So, Kenny Galladay is going to have a big year. It's just how will the Detroit Lions being really bad affect them? I don't know, because I love Kerryon Johnson as a runner and I love Kenny Galladay as a receiver. So how bad are the Lions really going to be? Because if their defense is terrible, then yeah, they'll be bad. But I would draft Kenny Galladay. That's my personal opinion. I think he'll be a solid RB2, if not almost an RB1. He's definitely on my sleeper list, right at the top. Chris Godwin and Kenny Galladay are my sleepers, value picks, all of that. Kenny Galladay, even more so than Chris Godwin, because Kenny Galladay is a number one receiver for his team. So, yeah, he'll get the double team, and Chris Godwin won't because of Mike Evans. But Kenny Galladay, he's got Marvin Jones, he's got other receivers, and Matthew Stafford is a very capable wide receiver. So Kenny Galladay, watch him. I know everyone's predicting it, but I'm just second it then. He's going to have a big year. Could be up in the 1,200 yards. Definitely a lot of touchdowns because, they're going to throw jump balls and fades for him. He's going to catch them. So Kenny Galladay will be a great fantasy option, especially if for some reason you play non-PPR. And draft Kenny Galladay, I guess, if you're a weird person and still doing that. So. All right, number 20, Tyler Lockett. I just think Tyler Lockett, now that Doug Baldwin's gone, Tyler Lockett's got to have a big year, and I think he's going to have a big year. There was that interview with ESPN Russell Wilson did where he said, Tyler Lockett's got to step it up, and he's going to step it up. He's saying he had a big year last year, but they're connecting even more. They're on the same page. He quietly had 10 touchdowns and a bunch of yards last year, and he did. Tyler Lockett's fast as hell. He's like a Tyreek Hill. He's not the poor man's Tyreek Hill. He's like up there close to as good as Tyreek Hill. Yeah, he's not nearly as fast or all that, but Tyler Lockett's just going to have a great season. Just watch. Russell Wilson, you trust him, right? So why not trust the Tyler Lockett without Doug Baldwin, he's a number one receiver. You know, who else they got? David Moore, Jaren Brown, a bunch of like random no names. And, you know, Chris Carson, they may run the ball more. That's the only downside. But Tyler Lockett's good for like an 80-yard touchdown reception every 1 to 2 games, maybe 2 to 3. So Tyler Lockett's definitely a very good choice if you get him. I think he's a solid RB2. I mean, Tyler Lockett's going to have a big year. I think he should be around that 1,000-yard range. Hopefully, I don't know if we'll have 10 touchdowns again, maybe 7, 8. But still, that's a great year. I mean, if you get Tyler Lockett as your third receiver, or even your second will be fine, but if you get Tyler Lockett on your team with a couple of good receivers, you're going to be very happy with that. You will not be disappointed, is all I say. I got Tyler Lockett as my wide receiver 3 on one team. Oh, they don't even know what they just did. So yes, draft Tyler Lockett with confidence. He's going to be great this year. Russell Wilson too. Damn, Seahawks always seem to sneak into the playoffs. They'll probably sneak into the playoffs again. So draft him, and even with a terrible offensive line, with Russell Wilson scrambling everywhere, Tyler Lockett will still be fine, and the Seahawks will somehow still be fine. All right, my honorable mention is DJ Moore. The only reason he's not Moore is because I love Curtis Samuel. He's a little joke, the only reason he's not Moore. But DJ Moore, he's their rookie last year, fast as hell, a little undersized, but still, he can catch everything and outrun everybody. He's shifty. DJ Moore has shown it last year, and now I don't think he'll have the sophomore slump. He's going to grow on last year's performance and just get better and better, have a really big year. I think Curtis Samuel will have a big year, too. I think Cam Newton, hopefully, as long as he stays healthy and gets back in plays, we can't do any backups, then this changes everything. But if Cam Newton does play, I think he'll want to prove the haters and doubters wrong, too. And Cam Newton could end up having a sneaky big year. And I think Curtis Samuel and DJ Moore will be the recipients of that. I have DJ Moore here just because I think he'll just be a little better than Curtis Samuel. DJ Moore is technically the number one. I think, both of those receivers you can't go wrong with. But DJ Moore, I think, will just have a little bit better of a year. I think he's going to really... He could break the 1,000 yards and a bunch of touchdowns, you know, with that kind of speed and everything. If he was a little taller, it'd be great, but that kind of speed, you know, he could break away from anybody, and so at any time, he'll be able to score if he wants to. I mean, not literally any time, but you get what I mean. DJ Moore is going to be a great player. He's going to make that jump, that echelon. Next echelon jump where he goes from middle of the road receiver to the top of the line class, not the leap, but the top of the line where next year I could see him maybe creeping around the top 10 wide receiver list. Like he's bound to have a big year, him and Curtis Samuel. It's not just a popular trendy pick. I think it's going to be real. You know, they're not flukes. They're not going to sophomore slump. At least DJ Moore, it's Curtis Samuel's I think third year. But DJ Moore is going to have no slump. He'll have whatever the opposite of a slump is, a non-slump here. So draft DJ Moore with some strong confidence. All right, I put AJ Green in the side because I don't know what's happening with his injury. Like, if AJ Green's healthy, though, he was just a top 5 wide receiver last year. So I would draft AJ Green if he's healthy. You know, I love his hands. He's a great receiver. Another quiet, like DeAndre Hopkins, is quiet, does his work. He can have a huge game, but yeah, he can also have some really dud games. I think like he literally had some zeros, ones, or twos. But he can also have your 30-point game. So AJ Green, if you can get him late, that's my best value pick because people are drafting him real low, like really undervaluing him. So. If you can get him real late, I would draft AJ Green. Don't have short-term memory loss. Remember how good he was. I don't care that it's Andy Dalton, the fierce ginger or whatever he's called. Draft AJ Green with confidence. Draft Tyler Boyd with confidence too, because he seems to be the trendy pick to blow up. And I think he will. I think he'll have a very good season. I think people are over-exaggerating how good he'll really be. Because I do think the Bengals will have a pretty bad year. I think they'll run a lot with Joe Mixon. So Joe Mixon will have a big year. But Tyler Boyd's a risky one, but I think he just had a couple big games, so he's a flashy pick to blow up. But I think he'll have a good year, though. Bengals will be a little better than people thought, which is maybe like 8-8. But, or no, they might be 9-7, maybe contending for a wild card spot. So I think, you know, depending on the health, draft A.J. Green and just check out Tyler Boyd, his status as time goes on, if you could get him on your team. I didn't get him, so, you know, I haven't been researching him a ton, but I think he'll probably have a really good year, be above average, you know, upper middle class range again. So, yeah, check out Tyler Boyd if you can. And don't forget about Josh Gordon, I was just going to say. I mean, Josh Gordon's back on the Patriots. They just activated him now. He is going to play. Remember how good of a target he was for Tom Brady, how much Brady did like him a lot, threw to him a lot. He got a lot of receptions and yards before he messed it up again. So if Josh Gordon can somehow, like I had confidence in him last year, and he crushed my spirits again, and I know all too well how that goes, so I'm a little nervous to pick him. I did happen to get him on one or two teams, just a stash in the back, so if Josh Gordon ends up playing, though, we know his talent, how good he is, so he's just a good guy to pick up at the end of the draft and stash in case he blows up and, you know, lives up to the potential we know he has. He could be one of your most smartest picks. He could really be the guy that, you know, makes that crucial edge you need and gets you to the championship, you know. It's really one not on your first picks and everything. It's really, fantasy is really one on your sleepers and your late round picks and how smart you are and what kind of value you get. So Josh Gordon would be some great late round value to pick up and stash to see how good he actually does this year. All right, some other picks I enjoy. K-Max, possible sleepers of the year. Robbie Anderson, love him. Love Sam Darnold and the Jets. I hate to say it, don't tell my brother. I hate the Jets in general, but I do love their offense. I love Le'Veon Bell, Robbie Anderson. I mean, I love those guys. And Sam Darnold throwing it to him, I do, unfortunately, think they'll have a pretty big year. So draft Robbie Anderson with confidence. He will play well. I mean, it's not like the Jets will beat the Patriots finally, and, you know, but they're in the division with the Dolphins, and I don't know, the Bills might be all right, but the Jets could get a wild card this year, and Robbie Anderson's going to be a big part of that team. Just no matter what, he's their number one receiver. I know they get Quincy and Nunwa back. I love Jameson Crowder, but I think Sam Darnold will spread the ball around. Robbie Anderson could finally make that big Pro Bowl leap he wanted and really become a number one receiver in the game. Be that Pro Bowl receiver that he begged for that year. I think Robbie Anderson will make it this year, so draft him with some confidence, definitely. All right, next, Alshon Jeffrey. I think draft without confidence. I just never have much faith in him. I don't have much faith in the Eagles or Carson Wentz in general right now, so I'd stay away from Alshon Jeffrey. Mike Williams, Will Fuller the fifth, I'd stay away from them also. They're in my do not draft list or draft at your own risk list. Draft at your own risk list. D.D. Westbrook, I think, could have a big breakout year. I like Jacksonville. I like Leonard Fournette having a big year. I like Nick Foles to have a pretty big year with them. Their defense will be good. So the Jacksonville Jaguars, especially with Luck out now, might be a sneaky big team. So I think you should draft D.D. Westbrook as their number one receiver. And, you know, he's got the size and the talent. He catches ball. D.D. Westbrook is finally, you know, he was a real touted rookie coming out. And I think he could finally, only injuries derailed him and other receivers, Marquise Lee and Allen Robinson, other guys getting the ball before him. He finally is number one now, ready to prove his talent and that he is a number one and here to stay. He's a Pro Bowl receiver. And I think he'll prove that now. He's healthy. He'll be in the Pro Bowl too this year. I really like him, you know, along with Robbie Anderson to be first-time Pro Bowlers. I do really like D.D. Westbrook this year, so draft him with confidence, you know. And you can thank me later when he makes the Pro Bowl and helps you win your championship. You can just send me a letter or email me or whatever, you know, DM me, ask for my number. I'll accept any form of thank you for that sleeper pick, D.D. Westbrook. All right, Emmanuel Sanders, I think, will still have a big year. People forget about the Broncos and their receiving core. I like Deshaun Hamilton, too. So draft Emmanuel Sanders or Deshaun Hamilton in your late picks. And Joe Flacco might still have one season of spark left. I hated Joe Flacco just as much as the next guy, but for some reason, I think he might be all right in Denver. I don't know why. I just sense he'll have a little bit of resurgence this year, and then he'll probably basically be retired next year. What about that one last flame, like a Brett Favre in Minnesota, one last flame? So Emmanuel Sanders, I do like again this year. He'll bounce back from surgery, and Deshaun Hamilton will really make a jump from no name to some name. People will know about him after this year. We won't be looking him up right now as I talk. But I think Sammy Watkins will have a big year. Allen Robinson, I think, will have a bigger year. I don't know how much. I heard the Bears were going to throw a lot this year. They weren't going to be just a running team. So Allen Robinson could have a sneaky, really huge year that I wasn't fully expecting. I'm just not sure on him, whether to call him a huge breakout sleeper pick or not. I don't know. I'm not sure on him. So iffy on Allen Robinson, but I think he will overall have a better season than last year. You know, to the down year, no doubt on that. So I think he'll have a better year this year. Sterling Shepard, I think, should have a big year. Him or Russell Shepard, because they're two different people, and it took me a while to realize. But Golden Tate suspended. You know, if they get Eli Manning out of there and Daniel Jones keeps performing the way he is and actually ends up being good, and I eat my words and, you know, I have to apologize to my best friend and everything. Sterling Shepard will have a big year because of that. He'll be the recipient of Daniel Jones' good throwing balls. So Sterling Shepard, it depends on the quarterback work, but you know, knowing the Giants, they'll stick with Eli and it'll get ugly and they won't play Daniel Jones. They'll just stick with Eli and maybe Sterling won't have a good year then, but I don't know. I think if they get Daniel Jones in there, it's crazy to say it. I can't believe I'm saying it. But if Daniel Jones gets in there, Sterling Shepard will probably have a very big year because they got no one else to throw to. Without Golden Tate there for four games or whatever, Sterling Shepard is the one besides Evan Ingram. I can't throw to him every time. So Sterling Shepard is bound to have a good year if they can actually get him the ball correctly. So look out for, if you can get Sterling Shepard late as a good value pick, definitely draft him. Christian Kirk, I also love him late. He's going to be the recipient. I know Michael Crabtree might mess it up, but I really love Christian Kirk this year. He started blowing up at the end of last year, had some big games. Now with Kyler Murray and their air raid offense with Cliff Kingsbury, you know they're going to throw the ball a million times. So even if he gets 10% of those, that's like 1,000 or 10,000, whatever. Christian Kirk's going to get the ball. They're going to throw it, that's for sure. You know, they're going to be throwing it all over the place. They're going to be losing. They're going to be, you know, down anyway. So they'll be throwing the hell out of that ball. They will throw the crap out of it. Someone's got to catch it. Can't be Larry Fitzgerald every time. Christian Kirk's going to have a big year. Watch. He'll really break out. He's going to have a big year. He was good in college, if you remember. He was at, Texas A&M or something? Or Oklahoma? I forget. Christian Kirk, though, he's big. He's fast. He's going to have a big year. Trust me on this one. You heard it here first. I feel like balling, guaranteed. K-Mac, guaranteed. I got to think of like a guaranteed fresh thing. Christian Kirk and Calvin Ridley, stamping out of both. Calvin Ridley, you know, started blowing up. It's Julio Jones number two. There's no more Muhammad Sanu out there. It's Calvin Ridley's number two job. And I really love Calvin Ridley. And I really love Calvin Ridley, just like everyone else, to blow up this year. I think he's going to become a really big elite receiver. I think he'll jump above upper middle class. He'll be elite in 2 years. Next year to 2 years, Calvin Ridley will definitely be elite. So if you're in a keeper dynasty lead, keeping Calvin Ridley will definitely be to your benefit. That'll be a good choice. Because, yeah, Calvin Ridley's on the rise to superstardom and greatness. He's going to get a big contract there. They'll probably trade Julio Jones and mess it all, whatever. But Calvin Ridley will be the number one receiver soon enough. He'll be, you know, one of the best in the game for sure. Just some other name, Curtis Samuel will be good this year. Watch out for him, obviously. Sleeper, Dante Moncrief in Pittsburgh. You know, besides Juju Smith-Schuster, who are they going to throw to? Dante Moncrief, who is their number two receiver. So I draft him. I think he'll get a lot of targets. And, in PPR league, you know, it'll be great to keep. You know, a lot of receptions, a lot of yards, maybe some touchdowns. Draft Dante Moncrief. I love Jamison Crowder in the slot. He'll get a lot of receptions and yards for Sam Darnold. Love their offense. Like I said, the Jets are going to be good on offense this year, and Jamison Crowder is going to have a really big year. If you're in PPR league, definitely get Jamison Crowder. He's going to have a really big year. Trust me. Corey Davis, he's like the number one receiver on the Titans. Everyone forgets they're even in the league. The Titans do still play in the league. They do have a team. They're going to play this year. They are going to field a squad. And Corey Davis is their number one receiver. He's so up and down. He's got such good size and speed and talents. You know, he can run in the open field and juke people out. He's shifty. You know, he's got all these skills, you know, and he's tall. I mean, he's got all the skills to be an elite receiver, but he never really quite gets there. He gets injured, or he just disappoints me. So I would say he's going to have a huge year and break out and really become that elite receiver we know he can become. But who knows? I don't know what Corey Davis will do. But he is the number one receiver for Marcus Mariota and the Titans. So if that excites you, if you think the Titans will be good for some reason, you know, or you know some insider information that we don't know, or you just love Marcus Mariota or something, I don't know. But Corey Davis could be a sneaky good pick. He could be a sleeper. I don't know. So if you like that whole situation, you're intrigued by that, you know, prove me wrong. Prove me as a sleeper. You know, try out Corey Davis. I just tried him last year. I have a sour taste in my mouth from it. You know, he was good sometimes and terrible sometimes. I think he threw up some zeros or ones or twos on me. So. We'll see how Corey Davis does this year. Maybe he will be everything we thought he was going to be last year. So I'm not going to predict it, but maybe someone else will. So draft Corey Davis if you want. You know, we already mentioned Geronimo Allison and Marquez Valdez-Scantling. Someone else has got to catch balls in Green Bay from Aaron Rodgers, one of the best quarterbacks in the league. So one of those guys has got to have, you know, RB2 or 3 value. Someone does. Anthony Miller in Chicago, if they really do throw as much as they say they will, he might have a breakout year. You know, he did have the second most touchdowns for a rookie last year, and they had a decent amount of yards. People just forgot because he's on the Bears, and I don't know, isn't that a big name? You don't hear much about Anthony Miller, so, you know, he quietly had a good rookie year, could have an even bigger second year. Marvin Jones Jr., I don't know, he might have some late round appeal. I love N'Keal Harry for the Patriots. Draft him. I think everyone's picking up on it, but he's the number two receiver for the Patriots, and they're a pretty good team, so I would draft N'Keal Harry. Last time, Tom Brady had a tall receiver, Randy Moss. That worked out pretty well for him, so I would draft N'Keal Harry if I were you. And I love Michael Gallup. Like I said, I think he's going to break out and have a huge second year. Dak Prescott will too. And Dak Prescott's going to throw it to Amari and Gallup. And Cowboys are just going to have a great year offensively, I think. So definitely draft Michael Gallup and Dak Prescott. If you got a 2 quarterback lead, draft him for your second. I think that'll be a great pick. You'll be really happy with that, and you'll get him really late. So I'd try to do it if I were you. But yes, definitely get Michael Gallup. Cortland Sutton, I kind of like him for the Broncos. Will he break out this year? I don't know. Let's see. Finally, DeSean Jackson, I don't know. He might have a sneaky big year. I just don't like the Eagles this year. I don't know if I draft him, but you can if you want. Larry Fitzgerald, I think he's a little overrated. Probably won't do much this last year. I think it's all about Christian Kirk and Michael Crabtree now, so don't draft Larry Fitzgerald. I love him. The guy had a great year. He'll have a great final year, but I don't think he has any fantasy value left. John Brown for the Buffalo Bills. He got traded there from the Ravens. He has sneaky appeal, you know, could be a little bit of a sleeper. I think I love Josh Allen in Buffalo. I really do. I think he'll run for a lot of yards. He's going to improve as a passer, that accuracy. I think Josh Allen's going to have a sneaky, huge year as a quarterback. He's going to have a really sleeper, big year. And John Brown, you know, he's got to throw it to someone. Zay Jones never steps up, so they traded for Cole Beasley, but, you know, he's just going to be in the slot. He'll catch small yards and everything. John Brown's their fast guy. They're going to throw deep balls. Like Josh Allen had that big arm. That's all that was said about him out of college. So he's going to throw some deep balls to someone. And they traded for John Brown specifically, a fast guy who runs go routes like that. So I'm just saying, you know, call me a conspiracy theorist. But I think they traded for John Brown to throw some deep balls from Josh Allen to him. So I would draft John Brown. You get him really late, put him on the back of your bench, and then watch the points rack in on your bench so you get pissed off and swear at the wall and the TV screen and possibly punch a few things you shouldn't punch, break a few fingers, shed some blood, whatever. Chicks dig it. All right, guys, I guess that's about it. Devin Funchess, will he still be good in Indianapolis without Andrew Luck? I don't know. You know, that's anyone's guess. So I'm not even going to touch that one. Not even going to give you a prediction. That's for the pros there. Go to ESPN or FS1 for that. Dante Pettis in San Francisco. I actually think George Kittle will take a step back, but I like Garoppolo to have a pretty big year, bounce back year. So, you know, a lot of people aren't talking about the 49ers, obviously, because they're the 49ers. So, but Dante Pettis was supposed to be like their number one breakout receiver this year. If you remember the ending of fantasy season last year, Dante Pettis was busted out. He was having a huge end of the year. So he keeps that up. I've only heard bad things out of training camp that other receivers were stepping it up and not Dante Pettis. So who knows? But if he does step it up in a Kyle Shanahan offense, Jimmy Garoppolo can get him the ball. Dante Pettis has a talent, clearly. Talent and skills last year he showed us to be a number one receiver. So will he do it, though, is the question. Dante Pettis, definitely an intriguing, if not probably really smart, bargain late value pick to pick up. All right, guys, this has been my top 20 fantasy wide receivers. I'm your host, Kevin K-Mac McCarthy. This has been another I Feel Like Ballin' special presentation from the people at the I Feel Like Rhyming channel. Thank you for watching all my videos. Please like, comment, and subscribe to the I Feel Like Rhyming channel. Tomorrow, episode 4 of I Feel Like Rhyming. We got plenty of things to talk about in the hip-hop rap world. I can't wait. I hope to see you there. And in 2 days, we'll be back for another episode of I Feel Like Ballin'. It will be my top 20 fantasy tight ends. If we can make it to 20, I will do it. I'll try to do it just for you guys, because I love each and every one of you specifically. Love all of you. All right, guys, once again, thanks for watching. Have a great day. I'm Kevin K. Mac McCarthy. This is I Feel Like Ballin'.